Good morning, everyone. Twelfth class accountancy. Chapter 2 and the last topic, guarantee. Guarantee of profits. So till now, we have done making of P&L appropriation account and past adjustments. And as you have seen that in past adjustments, you had prepared P&L appropriation. Afterwards, you have prepared the adjustment table. So similarly, in guarantee of profits also, the base is the P&L appropriation account. So in every question of guarantee, you need to prepare P&L appropriation. Then the last part of the P&L appropriation is the distribution of the profits. So at that time, we will work upon this topic, guarantee of profits. Till the question remains same, in the question profits will be given, then the appropriations will be given, and you will be making all the appropriations out of the profits, and afterwards, while distributing the profits, you will be working upon this topic, guarantee of profits. As the name implies, guarantee means that suppose you want to enter a partner, he is having good amount of money and he is ready to invest your money, but the condition is this, that he just want to be sure that he will be getting minimum of this much of profit. So he is asking for the minimum profits. So whenever you are asking for the minimum profits, it means you are giving a guarantee that at least this much of the profit will be there. So in case if profits are more, then the guarantee topic will not work upon. Yeah. Guarantee will work upon only when the profits are less. Yeah. If the profits are less and that person is not able to get the guaranteed amount, only then the guarantee will work upon. Otherwise, you need not to do the guarantee topic, adjustments if the partner is already getting the profits more than the guaranteed profit. For example, for better understanding, we can take one example. For example, A, B, R, and C are two partners and they are sharing the ratio equal and their profits are at the end of the year, after making all the appropriations, suppose their profits are 60,000. Okay, at the time of admission of C, it was written in the partnership deed that C is guaranteed a minimum profit of 30,000. A guarantee is given, C is guaranteed that a minimum profit of 30,000 is to be given him. Okay, so now first of all, we have to prepare the P&L appropriation account by net profits or by P&L account. 60,000 are the profits earned during the year. Suppose there is no appropriation or we have done all the appropriations already. So in this case, now it's time to divide the profits among A, B, and C profits to A, to B, and to C. So first of all, profits will be distributed in the given ratio. Clear? This is the ratio and these are the profits. So it means 20,000 each partner will be getting 1/3, 1/3, and C will be also getting 1/3. So 20,000, 20,000, 20,000 each. Now you have to compare. After this, you have to work on the guarantee. Okay. So till here, the question is same as already we have done in two topics, making of P&L appropriation account and past adjustment. Till here, there is no change in the solution. So after doing all the appropriation and after distributing the profits, now you will compare the actual profit of the partner to whom guarantee was given and the guaranteed amount. So this is the C's actual profit. So C is getting actually what amount of profit? 20,000. But what was his guaranteed profit? 30,000. So here, his actual profits are lesser than the guaranteed amount. Only in this situation, the guarantee will work upon. Okay, how it will work upon, I will be telling you. But this is the case when the guarantee will work upon. Now suppose A's share of profit is 40,000. And what was the guaranteed profit? 30,000. So in this case, you need not to work on guarantee topic. Okay, so we can say if partner's actual profits are more than guaranteed profits, you can write down this line. If partner's actual profit are more than guaranteed profits, then guarantee will not be done. Further proceedings for guaranteeing will not be carried forward. Okay. How, when the guarantee will work upon? Only when the actual profits are lesser than the guaranteed profits. So in that case, guarantee will be given to the partners. Minimum amount, guaranteed amount will be given to the partner. Now, how this guarantee will be given? So we know that in this example, the guaranteed profit is 30,000 and actually the partner is getting only 20,000. So the lesser amount is 10,000, okay, which we have to give the partner. Now, how this could be given? For this, write down, guarantee can be of basically in two types, guarantee by partner, guarantee by a firm, guarantee by firm, and then guarantee by a partner. Guarantee by firm and guarantee by partner. Guarantee by firm and guarantee by partner. Guarantee by firm means, suppose A and B and C are there and C is guaranteed the profits. Guarantee by firm means guarantee is given by all the remaining partners. You can write down guarantee by all remaining partners. You can draw the web charts like this. It will be easy for your understanding. Guarantee by all remaining partners. What does it mean? It means if the guarantee is given to C, it means who will be compensating C? A and B both will be compensating C. Here, guarantee by partner means there is no role of all the partners. It is mentioned in the question that who has given the guarantee. So in here, the individual partner will be given the guarantee by individual partner. Here, here guarantee by firm by all remaining partners. And here, guarantee by partner, guarantee by a single partner, you can write. It means the partner will be compensating to the guaranteed partner who has given the guarantee according to the question. So it must be mentioned in the question that who has given the guarantee. Here, so suppose the same example, same question. And there, the profit distribution was A, B, C, 20. 20 and 20. So suppose the guarantee was given by firm. Now one more thing is there. If the guarantee is given by firm, then you must be knowing that in which ratio the firm has given the guarantee. If question is silent, write down in the form of web chart. If the question is silent, then we will take the given ratio for guarantee. Whatever the ratio is given in the question, that will be taken in the beginning of the question. Sometimes the guarantee ratio is given. Guarantee ratio is given. In this case, guarantee will be given in the ratio which is given in the question for guarantee. Here. Just a minute. Yes. So here, suppose the guarantee is given by firm. Guarantee is given by firm. Firm means the remaining partners. So first of all, we will see that what was the ratio of the remaining partners. C is guaranteed and the remaining partners are A and B. And what is their ratio? 1:1. Don't consider the partner to whom the firm has given the guarantee. So the ratio is 1:1. So it means A and B must be compensating to C. And in what ratio? Ratio is given 1:1. So what is the lesser amount? C has got 20,000, but as per the question, he was guaranteed for 30,000. So the difference amount, 10,000 is there. And this difference amount will be given to C by A and B. Clear? C will be compensated by the other partners, A and B. So now one question must be coming in your mind that how they are going to compensate, in which ratio. So ratio is given. If no ratio is given for guarantee, then we will assume the ratio whichever is given in the question. In that ratio, the profits will be distributed. So 1:1. So we will subtract 10,000 from A and B's share in equal ratio. 5,000, you are going to write here guarantee to C. Clear? Then out of B also, guarantee to C, 5,000. It means now A will be getting 50,000, B will be also getting 50,000, and this both amount will be added in A's share. Add. This is less than add. Guarantee from A, 5,000, then guarantee from B, 5,000. So in this case, C is getting the minimum guaranteed amount, which is 30,000. And who has sacrificed for C? A and B. Basically, the partner who has given the guarantee will be sacrificing. But here, I am telling you the firm has given the guarantee. If in the question, it is not mentioned that who has given the guarantee, then we will assume that the remaining, all remaining partners have given the guarantee. Now, two things will be there. Either the guarantee ratio will be given in the question. If not, then the ratio which is given in the question, profit sharing ratio, that will be used for guarantee. Suppose in the same question, it is mentioned that ratio of guarantee. Ratio of guarantee is 3:2. So in that case, in the question, two ratios will be given. One is their profit sharing ratio and one is the guarantee ratio. So profit will be shared in the profit sharing ratio and the guarantee will work upon in the guarantee ratio. So suppose the guarantee ratio is 3:2. So in this case, we will be dividing the deficiency amount, which is 10,000, in 3:2. So which will be equal to 6,000 and 4,000. Here 6,000 and 4,000 means here will be 14,000 and here will be 16,000. But ultimately C will be getting 30,000. There will be no change in C, but here we will be writing 6,000 and here we will be writing 4,000. So what is important here to read the question? If the concept is clear, then you have to read the question very clearly and you have to decide what is the guaranteed amount, then from whom he will be getting the guarantee. Third point, is there any ratio for the guarantee given in the question? If not, then you can take the old ratio. If no ratio is given in the question, then equal ratio will be there. You all know that whenever there is no ratio in the question, then equal ratio will be there. Now let's do one question for better understanding of the topic. Wait a minute. And journal entry also I will be telling you from this question only. Just give me 1 minute. Yes, this is the question 49. In this question, A, B, C are partners in a firm. ABCR partners in a firm, and their profit sharing ratio is given. You can write, prepare the summary, ABC 3 partner, and their profit sharing ratio is 4:2:1. It is provided that C's share of profit would not be less than 37,500. What does it mean? It means C is being given a guarantee. C is being given a guarantee. And what is the guaranteed amount? 37,500. Profits for the year are given 1,57,500. Here, no appropriations are given in the question. If appropriations are given, then you need to do the appropriation. So I am waiting. So first of all, you have to just prepare the P&L appropriation account. So prepare P&L appropriation account, then we will be doing the next part of the question. So I am giving you just 1 minute for making of P&L appropriation. I hope you have done. It's just a simple calculation. You have to just divide the profits. So like this. Appropriation account. So first of all, we have to write the profits by profit and loss account. And what was the amount of profit? It's 1,57,500. Now divide this profit among ABC to A. Leave the space in between the division of the profits, as we will be in requirement of that space, because we have to take back the profits from few of the partners and we have to add that profit in one of the partners. So we have to leave the space. So what is the ratio? Ratio is, wait a minute, ratio is 4:1. This is the ratio, 4:1. So A will be getting 4/7, B will be getting 2/7, and C will be getting 1/7. So 157,500 into 4/7.
90,000.
Yes, what is the amount?
90,000.
Yes, it's 90,000. And amount for 45,000. And for C, it's 20,500. Now we have to check for the guaranteed amount. What is the guaranteed amount? So guaranteed amount is 37,500. So 37,500, but the actual profit, what he is getting is, yes, 22,500. So by what amount it's the lesser? So we have to do the subtraction.
15,000.
Yes, Hitesh, please don't interrupt in between better. 37,500, then 22,500, and the subtraction is 15,000. Here, and the figure is 15,000. So in this case, now we have to check for. So this 15,000 will be given by the partner or the partners who have given the guarantee to C. Now we have to check again the question to know that who has given the guarantee. And if question is silent, then we will assume that the firm has given the guarantee. So here you can see that only one thing is written. It is provided that C's share in profit would not be less than 37,500. It is mentioned in the question that the guarantee is given to C, but it is not mentioned that who has given the guarantee. So if it is not mentioned in the question, then we will assume that all the remaining partners have given the guarantee. So it is clear from the question that A and B has given the guarantee. Now you have to look for the ratio. What is the ratio for guarantee? Is it given in the question? If not, then you will be assuming A and B's profit sharing ratio. A and B's profit sharing ratio. So what is their profit sharing ratio? 4:2. Here you will not be including C for this, because we are just talking about A and B. So we need to consider their ratio only. So their ratio is 4:2, which means 2:1. Okay, 4:2, we have to reduce. If we are going to reduce it, in the lowest term, then it will be 2:1. So the guarantee is given by A and B, and their ratio is 4:2, which means 2:1. So 15,000 will be taken from A and B in the ratio 2:1 and given to C. So here I'm going to write less guarantee to C. So 15,000 into 2/3, 2:1. Clear? 10,000, it will be subtracted from here. It will be 80,000. Then 5,000 less guarantee to C, 5,000. So it is 40,000. So it means A and B are compensating to C for the guarantee given by the firm. Now the same amount will be added to C. Add guarantee from A. What is the guaranteed amount from A? 10,000. Guarantee from B, 5,000. And the total he is getting 37,500. And you can see he must be getting at least the guaranteed amount, and he is getting the guaranteed amount. If already he is getting more of the guaranteed amount, then I told you that guarantee will not be done. Guarantee topic will work out only when the partner's actual profits are lesser than the guaranteed amount. If the actual profits are more than the guaranteed amount, then guarantee will not work. Clear? Now suppose in the same question, the different ratio for the guarantee is given. In that case, you have to consider that ratio which is given for the guarantee. One ratio will be given for the profit sharing, and the other ratio will be given for the guarantee. We will be doing such type of questions also. But if there is only one ratio in the question, then you will be taking that ratio only for doing guarantee. And if in the whole question, no ratio is given, then for the guarantee, for the profit sharing, for everything, you are going to consider the equal ratio, because we already know that whenever ratio is not given in the question, then equal ratio is treated. Now the next important thing, what will be the journal entries for guarantee? So consider this journal entry here. On the basis of this P&L, there will be two journal entries, P&L appropriation. First journal entry, mostly the journal entries will be asked. So on the basis of this understanding, you can make your journal entry. First journal entry is the distribution of the profits. So when the profits were distributed, what journal entry we can pass? Write down the first journal entry. Profits are distributed. You all know the journal entry for distribution of profits. When the partners will be getting profits, their capital will be increasing. So the journal entry will be profit and loss appropriation account debit to A's capital if the capitals are fluctuating, and if capitals are fixed, then current account to B's capital to C's capital. So here in this entry, you need to write the actual amount of profit, what actually they were getting. It means before guarantee. So A was getting 90,000. B was getting 45,000 and C was getting 22,000, and the narration will be being profits appropriated. Now, this entry we have already done many times, so it is the simple entry which we were already doing. Now, in the second entry, A and B are giving their share of profits to C. Why? For compensating C. Actually, C was given a guarantee. So to compensate him, A and B are sacrificing their share for C. So what entry can be passed here? As A and B are giving their share to C, it means A's and B's capital is decreased and C's capital is increased. A's and, yes, very good. Yes, very good. Yes, very good. Shruti, very good. Hitesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. I'm waiting for some more answers. A and B are giving their shares to C. A's and B's capital is decreased and C's capital is increased. Whenever capital is decreased, it is debited. And whenever it is increased, it is credited. So I have got many answers. Very good, Siddhi. I am waiting for a few more answers. Very good, Ambika. A and B's capital will be debited and C will be credited. Very good. So the journal entry will be A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to C's capital account. You have to debit all those partners who have sacrificed their share to compensate C. Okay. So A has sacrificed by 10,000, B has sacrificed by 5,000. And C's capital is increased by 15,000. And the narration will be being guarantee given to C. That's it. No need to mention, no need to write the long narration. So being guarantee given to C. Being guarantee given to C. This will be the journal entry. So here we have done that. Both the partners have given the guarantee. If the question is silent, as I told you earlier, that who has given the guarantee, then we will assume that both the partners have given the guarantee. Now suppose it is mentioned in the question that A has given the guarantee. Only A has given the guarantee. It is mentioned in the question. Then what will be done? There is no need of ratio. Whatever the amount is short, then the guaranteed amount, that whole amount will be sacrificed by only C. There will be no role of B. Okay, so B will be getting his whole share, 45,000, and the 15,000, whole 15,000 will be subtracted from A's share, like this, 15,000. So it means 75,000, 45,000, and here also little bit change will be there. Now C has got his share only from A. So we are going to write guarantee from A, which is 15,000. So the thing is this, you have to just act upon the information given in the question. Yes, sir. Yes, Harshita, you can leave. Okay, so you have to act upon the information given in the question. So if the question is silent about the information that who has sacrificed, in that case, all the remaining partners will have to sacrifice. And if it is clearly mentioned in the question that partner A has sacrificed, then there is no need of any ratio. The whole amount, difference amount will be subtracted from A's share. And if it is mentioned that B has sacrificed, then there will be no role of A and the whole amount will be subtracted from B only. Means it does not matter that who is sacrificing. What matter is that C is to be given the guaranteed amount at any cost. So either it must be mentioned, and if it is not mentioned, then the remaining partners means if there are three partners, and C is given a guarantee, it means remaining partner here are A and B. So they must be sacrificing their share for compensating C. So now if two partners are there, then there must be a ratio, because you have to subtract the amount in a given ratio. So ratio must be given in the question. If guarantee ratio is not given, then you can work upon the profit sharing ratio. And if guarantee ratio as well as profit sharing ratio, nothing is given, then for each and everything, you are going to use the equal ratio. I hope I am clear. Now we will do some practice questions.